now that you guys seen my little conference call this morning, I was put on hold, so I figured I'd give you guys a little bit of jamming session, show you my dance skills. Anyways, so we're back with a Chevelle update. As you can see, that was just on here. And the reason why we're doing this, many reasons actually, it's gonna allow me to easily build the turbo manifolds. As you can see, I have the merge collectors mocked up. They ain't going nowhere, both sides. I'll explain to you guys. See, this is right here. This one moves a little bit, but that's okay. I'm gonna explain to you guys. If you guys look closely, I don't know if you guys are gonna be able to capture this, but the way that the Borg turbos are, they're not Garrett Motion turbos. Garrett Motion has developed a turbocharger so you can do reversed mounting. So it spools pretty much opposite direction than a regular turbo. They're, I guess you could say, wouldn't call it bi-directional, but opposite direction basically. So he opted out to do a Borg turbo, perfectly fine, but this, in order to make it fit and don't, it doesn't hit the valve cover all the way, you have to clock the turbo and the exhaust housing closer to the fender well. So it really doesn't, it's not, I guess you can say it's not symmetrical from each side, but I'm gonna do what I do best and I'm gonna make it look really aesthetically pleasing. So I'm not really too worried about that. But the frame is off the chassis, or the body is off the frame, sorry, because this thing is getting completely stripped down. We're doing a, we're boxing the frame, we're reinforcing the frame. We're gonna be, I think we're gonna talk tomorrow with him about doing a drag mount, because he's been sending me some links, some pictures. So a drag mount, as I mean a parachute mount. So this thing's going and getting blasted. Today's project is we're gonna mock up the at least one runner. I have every measurement I need, so I know where the steering shaft is, I know where the brake booster is, and so on and so forth. So we're gonna mock up each one runner, if not two, on each side. And then the engine's getting pulled because it's getting opened up for boost. And you can't, it's, if it's a high compression engine, you throw boost at it, they're not gonna be happy together, basically. So what we're doing is we're gonna pull the engine out, transmission's coming out, this is getting blasted, it's coming back, we're gonna do a whole bunch of fab work on the frame, it's getting sent off again, painted or powder coated, we're not too sure yet, and then we'll come back for final assembly, putting a bigger rear end in it, a bigger transmission. You guys will see every step of the way for this build. Like I said, the body came off, we're putting poly mounts on, so that's what we got into. Make sure you guys like, comment, subscribe, and share this video, because at 500 subscribers, you guys can't forget, don't sleep on this 500 subscriber giveaway. We're giving away a Holdfast wheel and a NRG quick release setup, so that includes a hub and a quick release for your application for one winner. At 1,000 subscribers, I got a really good giveaway. I'll give you a little hint, it is a standalone. So at 1,000 subscribers, be looking out for that. We're working our way out, we're definitely coming back into the swing of things, because we're really busy. It's super hard to kind of bounce back and forth between videos and doing you know, actual customer work, but we're trying our best. So we have a lot of things planned for this year. Doing cages, turbo kits, dynos on the way. Can't wait for that thing to show up, so let's get to it. So, to continue on the turbo manifold build, this is what we got so far. I'm gonna show you guys a little secret. Some, as you can see, it's really tight fit in here. Steering shaft goes in between here. So we gotta make sure that he can access all these spark plugs and doesn't require a whole bunch of disassembly just to install this. First and foremost, I don't know if you're gonna be able to see this, but this is it's about a 30 degree bevel. In order to weld proper scheduled pipe and get good penetration so you don't have any kind of cracking, you have to bevel it. I've seen a lot of people just like kind of butt them together, and it doesn't exactly work. It might get you by for now, but to get a proper weld inside and out, because we always back purge, make sure you guys do that. A back purge weld, it welds the inside as you're welding the outside, and the bevel really does help a lot. So what we have right now, we have a couple pipe down here, a couple scheduled 10 pipes, and we're just gonna go ahead and tack this into place and see if we have to do any kind of adjustment. We're just, like I said, we're gonna plan on just doing one runner on each side, and then we'll remove the actual, you know, flange and manifold for the merge collector, and we'll build off of that afterwards. So let's get these things tacked. Now that looks sweet. The fitment on that, good. Boom, all the way down, tacked. So I have an idea how this is all gonna go. This is gonna come out, loop in, and then this one, gonna loop down here, sorry. So this is gonna loop down in here. This one's gonna kinda go in 180 down in there. And then this is the bottom one for number seven initially. So, but yeah, it came out pretty good. This is where I wanted it. I just gotta add a few more tacks. But right now we're gonna start on the other side. So I already have, this one gonna be going. Gotta get this oil dipstick too, by the way, but that's where that's gonna be going. And then I'm gonna have one that just follows the same way, come up, and then this will hit this one right here, and then we'll figure out the rest afterwards. So let's get this thing going. Got the other manifold tacked up. So we just got two more runners to run and finish up the one runner. But the fitment on this bad girl. Look at that. Zoom in for you.
That's what I'm saying. It came with the car. And yeah, for it to, my buddy with the Monte Carlo, I took him for the ride. And God damn, like it, you know, that just shifts.
Now the new one, I know is
good. I have to, unless you want your butt crack on YouTube.
It's tattooed, so it's good. Right. That's why I did it.
What?
Yeah,
you got,
dude,
a tattoo on your...
Yeah, I got a whole back piece that goes into my butt crack.
Okay.
I was like, what are you talking about?
Yeah.
And you don't gotta rev this one up.
Nice. I mean, obviously...
Ain't bad for pretty much $600.
Right. Jesus.
Dude, that's a $7,000 forklift. Dude's like, hey. So, He didn't know if it ran.
Did you have some trouble like it shifted. Started on one? Okay,
yeah.
Oh, shifting.
He thought it was a transmission.
Ready?
Yeah.
So now that we got the 540 and the transmission taken out of the Chevelle frame, starts the next process of the build. So we have to completely strip everything off the frame and get ready for blasting. So I think at that note, we're gonna leave off and we're gonna start another segment of the next process of the build. we are gonna start, oh, wrong side. We're gonna start prepping Tony's cage. But first, before we do that, he left us a little surprise. Yeah, both sides are like that. So, you know, before we do any kind of cage in a car, you know, the car has to be structurally sound. So, safety-wise, I'm not going to cage a car like that until it's fixed. So, that's our next project. We're going to get going on that. Letting these lights warm up because it's freezing outside. It's not really cold in the shop, but let's go show you the Ohio. It's been crazy. I know Texas got hit with snowstorm too, but we need to relocate to Florida ASAP. But hope you guys enjoyed this video. Another video will be out hopefully today. This video will be out in the next couple days. We're gonna keep continuing on with these builds and getting things squared away. Patiently waiting for that dyno as well. Again, another plug for that 500 subscriber giveaway. I know I keep pushing it. 500 subscribers, you're getting a Holdfast wheel and NRG quick release setup that is pertaining to your vehicle. So make sure you guys like, comment, subscribe, and share. See ya.